All right, guys, heading into keeping the main thing, And for the main thing this week, boom, this one's going to be kind of interesting because here you have a father and a son, and we're going to be talking about God the Father and how he disciplines those of us right. that he loves. And I'm going to tell you right now, this man has disciplined me quite a few times. Even very recently, okay.
Like we're not gonna get personal.
Okay? You know, gotta be honest, right? Integrity's okay. Integrity's a big deal.
Integrity's a big deal. But it is.
This verse, the verse that we're gonna use this week for communicating this idea really stuck out to me because a lot of people, especially in today's day and age, right. Discipline in the context of like a parent disciplining a child can be a very hot button topic, right? Especially when you want to start talking about like to spank or not to spank, right? Or like, do you allow your kid this? You know, I think somebody called Hannah and I free range parents.
And what does that mean?
It's the idea that we let the kids go outside and run around. Right. Just be
in your yard
kids. Yeah. Like, I give Carson like a pretty good, he's got about a half mile radius. Now I let him go over to the park around the pond and stay in the neighborhood, you know, which sure. is within shouting distance.
Isn't he going on 11?
He is going on 11.
You know? Yeah.
Yeah. That's okay. what I'm saying. But it's like, they were like, you let your kid go that far. I was like, my parents let me walk 5 blocks down to the library when I was like 8. Like, what do you mean? You know, but anyway, yeah. So this could be like a really hot topic, right? A really hot button topic, but it really stuck out to me because the idea is that God loves us. So therefore he doesn't let us languish in our badness. You know, in those things that are dragging us down. And so in order to pull us out of that, right, sometimes it takes like a little, you know, and it does. It takes some discipline. So,
yeah. Yeah. I mean, disciplining people in different ways. Okay. So I'll just bring you and your brothers into this.
What, a pastor telling stories about his kids? Is
it yeah. never done that before. What? Anyway,
this is new territory.
So you were very cerebral, and so it was one of the great things that helped me a lot is that when it came to physically disciplining you, that was something that I didn't have to do. I could talk to you. And tell you why, and that reasoned with you really well. You accepted that, and I never was a parent, at least I didn't think so, that had a problem with you going, why? Good, ask me, right. and I'll tell you. But you weren't one of those kids that asked why just to go, why?
Well, why? And sticking up why? For myself just a little bit to one of the things that made this particular relationship that you're talking about work as well, is that I also didn't ask why maliciously. Like
That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I didn't ask why. So that way is we have a saying at work, you know, one of the things that makes a good Green Beret is I know the rules well. So that way I know how to break them, like how to get away with them. Right. It's one of the jokes around the office. But it's like that's not the way that I was when I was growing up. I wasn't learning the why of what you were saying just so that I could get away with.
Your intent behind asking why is you wanted to know. Yeah. And when you wanted to know, it satisfied you and it put us into that trust. I'm giving you information and you handling it. You learned a lot from it. And that was really good. And so I just bring that in because, you know, your brother could care less about the why. he, you know, it was, well, you know.
Shout out, you know which one you are.
if I do this, what are you going to do to me? Yeah. that was totally his. And in that discipline, so, you know, I'm not afraid. I'm from back in the day, a swat on the butt. That was the deal. Yeah. But if I could talk to you and didn't need to go that route, I would do that and try to talk to your brother. And to do that, it was like in one ear and out the other. So he needed to discipline, but the swat on the butt didn't work for him either. But if I told him, hey, the rest of us are going to go somewhere and you're going to sit right there, that was killer.
Mm-hmm.
That was absolute killer. And so you develop discipline. I only bring that up because God's discipline is if we as good fathers, this is a scripture, that if we and good father knows how to give good gifts and know how to discipline correctly in order to get the thing across, how much better does our Heavenly Father know how to discipline us? I'm changing the words there, but how to give good gifts is what it says. Yeah. And discipline is a good gift.
Right.
Now, a lot of people would argue that with me, but it is a good gift.
It really is.
Because for as many as God loves, he will discipline. Yep. Do you realize what the opposite of that is?
Right. I don't care. I don't care about you. And if I don't care about you at all, then what do I care what you do or how you turn out or that you're hurting? Or that you're doing something that's bad for you.
If God is not disciplining you, that means he is indifferent to you. If God is indifferent to you, he just doesn't care.
Which isn't true of our God.
But when he goes, this is the thing. I take my hands off. You're on your own.
Yeah, and that's terrifying.
I care. But I'm done with disciplining you. I'm done with doing something with you. I've tried, and you don't want to accept it. I've done it lovingly. This is the thing. I take my hands off.
Yeah.
And that should be what scares people to death.
Yeah, that's terrifying.
You're going through the hardships, the hard times, and you're going, man, this is now you got to be. Right on. Is this really God disciplining you, or is this the consequences?
The natural consequences of your
act. Yeah, you know.
God, why do you always give me your toughest battles? Listen, Greg, I'm not the one that told you to drink 12 beers last night.
I've said the other thing. Okay, God, why am I battling the issues with my health? Well, you know, you've been downing a half dozen donuts every other day since you were 15 years old. You know, that's my guilt. Okay. Okay, God, why are you taking us through this unwanted pregnancy? shouldn't have been screwing around outside of marriage. You with me? Yeah. I mean, there are natural consequences. Right. So we want to make sure that that's not what we're talking about. But there are things that God does that allows to come to you that are his disciplines. They are, he's putting you into a corner, or he's got you into a situation that becomes hard and is allowing you to go through that situation. Okay, God, why are you doing this to me? I thought you loved me. I do. I guess, and because I'm paying attention to you, I love you. And if all of a sudden you find yourself and God is indifferent to you, it should scare you to death.
Absolutely.
Because that means that if I take this scripture seriously, and do you have the scripture, by the way?
I do. So this is what,
if you take this scripture seriously and God is not dealing with you, that means he's indifferent towards you. Means he's withdrawing his love from you.
So
read that, folks.
Guys, here we have Hebrews chapter 12, beginning in verse 4. This is our BibleGateway.com. In your struggle against sin, you have not yet resisted to the point of shedding your blood. And have you completely forgotten this word of encouragement that addresses you as a father addresses his son? It says, "My son, do not make light of the Lord's discipline and do not lose heart when he rebukes you, because the Lord disciplines the one he loves, and he chastens everyone he accepts as his son."
He wants to treat you like a son. That is what he wants to do.
Right.
If he's not doing that.
Right. So wrapping a bow around it this week, guys, the thing is, you should be, as uncomfortable as it might make you, you should be seeking the Lord's discipline. Like, you should be putting yourself in a place that the Lord can discipline you, and you are feeling his loving rebuke because, and I have felt this in my own life, because when you remember that scripture that we just read to you, it's almost like getting a big hug right after you get spanked by your dad, that you remember it's because God loves me that he is disciplining me. Man, I'm getting mush mouth. He only wants you to be better. He only seeks to bless you and to give you a joyful life.
That is a great point, and I know that we got to go, but he only wants a better life for you. Oh, really? He's disciplining me because he wants a better life for me. Yes, because he knows that your actions are going to destroy you and take you down a path that is literally going to be hell. And he's trying to get that out of your life.
I hate it when people say literally, but literally.
Literally.
Hell.
Going to be hell. Ends. But he wants that out of your life so that you can live and live better. And he knows what that is. Right. And so, you know, his rules aren't just rules to be rules. His rules are there so that you can have a great life.
Amen.
A blessed life.
And that's the same thing that we want for you guys too. For you guys to live a blessed, healthy, fulfilled, and joyful life, which is why we bring you guys these little nuggets of scripture each week. I hope you guys enjoyed that. The Keeping the Main Thing segment. I hope that if you haven't, make sure you're catching up with us on the big idea this week and then the headlines.
Yep.
Who's who and what's new. Guys, have an awesome and a blessed week, and we'll see you guys back here next week on the Common Freaking Sense podcast. Make sure you follow, get subbed up, share the video with a friend to help us grow the channel.
Yep, and we will see you in just a week.
It's only a week.
Take care, everybody.
Take care.